Hey everybody, what's up? My name is Matt and welcome to Downshift. I have something very special for you today. I am with the M3 murderer, the AMG assailant, Motor Trend's car of the year, the fastest car with a trunk and four doors to lap the Nürburgring, the Alfa Romeo Giulia Quadrifoglio. So as we get into the details of the car, I want to talk about what makes this car so fast. To begin with, you have an active carbon fiber front splitter that will deploy at 60 miles an hour to generate excessive downforce. From there, you have great air intakes at the front, bringing all the cool air into the engine, keeping it cool and running smoothly. Additionally, you have a carbon fiber hood, as well as a carbon fiber roof for weight savings and rigidity. Of course, 14-inch Brembo brakes aren't too bad either. Look at those are so pretty and a nice red contrasting with the gunmetal wheels. Additionally, super fat Pirelli P0 summer rubber is equipped on this car to make it extremely sticky. Additionally, an air extractor behind the front tires is there to manage airflow. And I don't think this carbon fiber sill adds to anything, but it does look pretty cool. Of course, there's a carbon fiber lip spoiler on the trunk as well, with protrusions on the sides. Quad exhaust is staggered and is a beautiful shape in the black rear diffuser. And of course, the exhausts are straight to the pipe. They're not fake at all. The four-leaf clover is an emblem for this Quadrifoglio and has a beautiful story behind it regarding an Alfa Romeo racing driver. There will be an article on my website in the description below. Moving into features, we start with my favorite and keyless entry. The trunk has a weird quirk. The button on the left locks the entire car. The button in the right opens the trunk, and of course you have a rear view camera, parking sensors, and a radar up in the grille for radar cruise. Again, like I said, radar cruise and lane keep assist are options on this vehicle and are equipped with this model, as well as voice commands and all sorts of other things. You can control everything through the head unit here. It has got a vertical orientation rather than horizontal, so you can pair your phone to take calls, listen to music, and do things like access your navigation screen as well. Nothing is too reinventing the wheel here, but don't fix what's not broken. Everything is controlled by a very clean and subtle design with this wheel here. The gear selector is digital, so it's black plastic until you turn it on and see the lights. If you don't want to look at cup holders, you are bathed in carbon fiber, not just on the exterior, but in the interior as well. Additional features like dual automatic climate control with three-level heated seats and heated steering wheel are also equipped on this vehicle. Moving down from the head unit, you see you have a USB charging port right there. However, you also have two more in your center storage bin, along with a 12-volt outlet and an auxiliary port for music connectivity if you don't want to use the Bluetooth. Music will come through Harman Kardon sound systems. Beautiful accents like the Alfa Romeo badge are embossed into the headrest, as well as alcantara and leather upholstered seats on the front and rear. Little details such as the massive shift paddles have the plus and minuses, not stickers, but actually cutouts in the paddles. And of course, looking at a red start-stop button on your carbon fiber wheel isn't bad either. Moving into the rear, I was actually shocked by how much room I have. I have plenty of leg room in front of my knees, and I have about 2 to 3 inches, maybe even a little bit more, of headroom. Rear seat amenities include dual climate control vents and another USB, making it four chargers. One little quirk that I like to point out, and that took me by surprise, is the shape of the door jamb. It doesn't go back in one solid motion like normal, but has two little cutouts. Just an interesting quirk. Now, enough about features, let's drive this thing. All right, everybody, we are behind the wheel of the Alfa Romeo Giulia Quadrifoglio. Oh my God. So is this, I know the exhaust is dynamic. You can like change the note, yes? Mm-hmm. Is it on the loudest setting now?
So it's just on now. It's like, once it revs up, it'll
once it gets past a certain RPM.
Yeah, if you go into the race mode, it'll always be open.
Yeah.
And then that's also going to turn off all your driver's assist stuff, so it'll turn off traction control and all that stuff.
Yeah. So race mode will tighten up the dampers, quicken up the shifts, and turn traction control off.
Yep.
So this is probably a really unfortunately named feature in this car, but it's called IBS, which for those of you that don't know is irritable bowel syndrome, but it's also intelligent braking system in this car. And essentially what it means is braking by wire. All right, I'm gonna do a little pull. Turbo spool. Right about 4,000. 4,000 is when the exhaust really lets you know what's going on. God, this steering wheel feels so good. It's the Alcantara right at the end of your fingertips and leather right in your palm. It feels really, really good. Which is a weird thing to say, but it does feel good. All right, so I have been just kind of taken away with taking in the car, but we have a 2.9 liter twin turbocharged V6 giving you 505 horsepower. Yeah, that's quite a bit more than the M3 and even more than the Mercedes C63 AMG S. So there's a whole lot of power here. And I believe torque is, what was it, 443?
I believe it's
443, yeah. Which is still incredible. And the best thing about this car is it's small. It feels small and tossable and nimble and light and agile. It feels like it really wants you to drive it, which is just great. On the topic of this car being small, it's just about 3,300 pounds. It is light, and that's the whole point. So when you get the German cars, you get the Mercedes, the Audi, the BMW, those are more refined vehicles in like everyday traffic. But this car, this is the one you're gonna wanna take to the track. This is the one that's gonna perform and blow your mind every time you toss it into a corner. It's so light and tossable, it's just incredible. So I was watching a Matt Farah video earlier today, actually, in preparation for this video, just to get his thoughts. And he was saying that this car, the Alfa Romeo Giulia Quadrifoglio, has a better power to weight ratio than a Camaro Z28. That's essentially a race car. And this thing, oh, this thing is pretty sweet. Oh my God, the steering is so precise. It's not so lightly weighted like it is in BMWs where you worry you're gonna sneeze and end up in a ditch, but it's so precise and it's weighted correctly so you feel like you really have complete control over the vehicle and where it's gonna go. So drive modes, we have A, which is, I think, Advanced Eco.
Advanced Efficiency.
That'll essentially turn off half of the cylinders, so it'll shut down one cylinder bank, so you're running on three cylinders. That's gonna obviously be intended for increased efficiency, miles per gallon, everything like that. Then you have N, which is natural, and that's just your kind of daily cruising speed or cruising kind of feel with the softer dampers, not so aggressive shifting, things like that. Then D is dynamic. So you have D and race, which are more or less the same things, except race gives you a little bit more with the whole turning off of the traction control and things like that. But the dynamic mode, the D, that's really gonna be more sporty oriented as well. Oh, I meant to turn back there. Oh! Oh my God! Holy crap, this thing is fast. Oh my God. So, I wasn't sure whether or not I was going to take a certain turn right there. I decided to turn at the last second, and this thing did not care at all. It was like, sure, we can turn. This is like a 90 degree turn at like 40 miles an hour. It's fine, no big deal. And then you get on the power, and it's just, oh! And there's just exhaust burbles at upshifts, and oh my God, it's incredible. This may be, and I'm sorry, Randy, about the R8, but this may be one of the most fun cars I've ever driven. Oh my God. It does take a second for the turbos to spool up, but once you get there, it's just all kinds of power. Shit. That was insane. So this car is actually not equipped with the carbon ceramic brakes, but I don't feel like I need them. The brake-by-wire thing, it's nice, and it gives you a lot of bite right at the front. But it gives you plenty of braking power. It's really no problem. I don't feel the need to spend $8,000 on carbon ceramics. And Adam was saying it's like $3,500 to replace it, so I don't know why you would need to do that unless you're consistently tracking this car and you're worried about brake fade. One thing too to mention is, this is an Italian car, but it's really comfortable. I mean, the seats are exceedingly comfortable. These are the touring seats. You can get the sport performance seats. Those are carbon fiber Recaro buckets. Those things are just nasty, but these are super comfortable. The bolstering is really nice. It's on my sides. I mean, when I pitched into the corner just now, like, I didn't feel like I was gonna fly around anywhere. It was really nice. God, this thing is just so light. I love the steering. The steering is so direct.
Oh. Your drive mode will change the steering feel too.
Yeah.
Like if you go into the natural, it's gonna loosen up some more.
Yeah. So a lot of the Alfa ads campaigns, I'm sure you've seen them on TV, their whole thing right now is, this is the fastest four-door sedan on the Nürburgring. So Alfa went in with a six-speed manual, set the record, and then Porsche got very offended, as Porsche does, and they brought their Panamera turbo out, and they beat the Alfa time with the six-speed manual by like a second or two. Then Alfa was not having any part of that. They came back with the eight-speed ZF transmission, and they dusted the Porsche time, and you can really feel it. I mean, this car is fast, and it lets you know all the time between the exhaust, and I have to say, the exhaust sounds incredible for a V6, and especially a forced induction V6. It's amazing. It doesn't sound like, it sounds like a V8. I shouldn't say that. It doesn't sound like, but it sounds amazing. This is essentially, well, I can't say essentially, this actually is the Ferrari California T engine, and then they went and chopped two cylinders off and put turbos on it. So you're getting a Ferrari engine for $80,000 in the fastest four-door sedan in the world. That's worth it to me. This is a really fun little car. Yeah, I'm amazed. I'm impressed. The Germans, the BMWs, the Mercedes, the Audis, the M3s, the C63s, they're all nice. But you don't get the same feeling of just like raw athleticism from the vehicle that you get with this. This car is like constantly begging you and kind of pushing you, like, let's go faster. Let's take that corner a little harder. Let's push it. It's really something. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. That is the Alfa Romeo Giulia Quadrifoglio. I didn't spend a whole lot of time with this car, but the time I did spend, my mind is completely blown. I don't even want to hear AMG. I don't want to hear M. I don't want to hear RS5. This car is $80,000, but it is worth every single penny. You essentially have a Ferrari engine in one of the lightest, tightest, most nimble chassis out there. It's an absolute bargain, people. This car is absolutely incredible. Also, at this point, I would love to thank International Autos for making this review possible. They have taken extremely great care of me, and they have a fantastic selection of these Quadrifoglios out on their lot right now, so please go check it out there in West Dallas on Highway 100. Really, you need to go look at this car. This thing is incredible. So with that, again, I hope you really enjoyed this video. As always, leave a comment, subscribe, let me know what you want to see down in the comments, and have a great day. We'll be right back.